The Missing Coach. Soon workmen came to give the twins their numbers. Donald was 9 and Douglas 10. When the men went away, they were left alone in the shed. "You may have noticed, Dougie, that yon painters forgot something."
"What did they forget?"
"They painted braw new numbers on our tenders, but they put none on us." Donald winked broadly at his twin.
"You mean," grinned Douglas,
"that we can..."
"Just that," chuckled Donald. "Who'd you wished? Here's the inspector."
"No 9 and 10, smiled the inspector. "Here's Duck. He'll show you round before you start work." The twins enjoyed themselves and were soon friends with Duck. They didn't mind what they did. They tackled goods trains and coaches easily. But once the twins had shunted them, trucks knew better than to try any tricks. "We like it fine here," said Donald.
"That's good," smiled Duck. "But take my tip. Watch out for Gordon, Henry and James. They're sure to try some nonsense."
"Get a fash yourself," chuckled Douglas. "We'll soon settle them." Donald and Douglas had deep-toned whistles.
"They sound like buses," said Gordon.
"Or ships," sniggered Henry.
"Tugboat Annie," laughed Gordon. "Ha ha ha."
Donald and Douglas cruised quietly up, one on each side.
"You wouldn't they be making fun of us, would you now?" asked Donald.
Gordon and Henry jumped. They glanced nervously from side to side. No, said Gordon. No, certainly not, said Henry.
That's fine, said Douglas. Now just mind the both of you, and keep it that way.
That was the way Gordon and Henry kept it. Every day, punctually at 3:30, Gordon steams in with the express. It is called the Wild Nor'Wester, and is full of people from England, Wales and Scotland. There is also a special coach for passengers travelling to places on Thomas's branch line. When the other coaches are taken away empty, engines have to remember to shunt the special coach to the bay platform. It doesn't wait there long. Thomas, with Annie and Clarabelle, comes hurrying from the junction to fetch it. Thomas is very proud of his special coach. One afternoon, Douglas helped Doug in the yard, while Donald waited to take a goods train to the other end of the line. As Duck was busy arranging Donald's trucks, Douglas offered to take away Gordon's coaches. Douglas was enjoying himself when an awful thought struck him.
"I hope the fat controller doesn't find out I shouldn't be here. I couldn't abide going back."
He worried so much over this that he forgot about Thomas's special coach. He pushed it with the others into the carriage siding, then ambled along to join Donald at the water column. As he went, Thomas scampered by, whistling cheerfully. Soon Thomas came fussing.
"Where's my coach?"
"Coach?"
asked Donald.
"What coach?"
"My special coach that Gordon brings for me. It's gone. I must find it."
He bustled away.
"For sake," said Douglas. "I more than stowed the special coach with the others."
"You see that?" exclaimed Donald's driver. A mob of angry passengers erupted from the siding.
"They're complaining to the fat controller. He'll be coming here next."
"Now listen," said Douglas's driver. "We'll change tenders. Then I'll wire with ye, Donald, and take yon goods. Dinna fash about us. Quick now, do as I say."
And three passengers walked towards them. But Donald, with Douglas's tender, number 10, was out and away with the goods before they came near. Douglas and his driver waited with innocent expressions.
"Ah," said the fat controller, "number 9. And why have you not taken the goods?"
"My tender is a wire, sir."
The driver showed him the tender, still uncoupled.
"I see. Some defect, no doubt. Tell me, why did number 10 leave so quickly?"
"Maybe, sir," put in Douglas, "he saw you coming and thought he was late."
"Ah,"
said the back controller. He turned to the passengers.
Here, gentlemen, our facts. Number 10 has been shunting the yard. Your coach disappeared. We investigate. Number 10 disappears too. You can draw your conclusions. Please accept my apologies. The matter will be investigated. Good afternoon, gentlemen.
The fat controller watched them till they climbed the station ramp. His shoulders twitched. He wiped his eyes. Douglas wondered if he was crying. He wasn't. He swung round suddenly.
Douglas, he rapped. Why are you masquerading with Donald's tender?